obviously we brought Paul Cooke on to in the dugout today. Obviously, I've already mentioned we're not in the dugout because it's freezing out there. So we're sat in my office. First of all, Cookie, couple of new signings we've made. First one, Alex Gilby. Just give us a bit of a heads up on him, please.
Yeah, young boy from Hull. Played in the 19s at OKR, and unfortunately for him, has been released. But you know, like a lot of the young players nowadays that get released at that age, you know, there's nowhere for them to play at their club. So we've taken some advice from a good friend of mine, Dave Allstock, and Craig Murdoch, and with a bit of luck, he'll turn out to be one of the good ones for us. He's a centre, plays centre back row. Strong boy physically, be able to cope with the demands of the Championship, which is important. And it's up to him really how much he plays. Similar to Richard Wilkinson last year with Alex Starling, Ryan Wilson, who we brought in from Hull. And it's up to them how they apply themselves with their attitude and how much game time that they gain through their performance.
Yeah, I went in and signed him yesterday, and he's a fair size.
Yeah, he's a big boy. Yeah, physically, and that's something that we look for with regards to them positions, that you know, they've got to be able to cope with the demands of playing against big men. And when you come out in 19s, that's maybe a bit of a shock to some players, and they can't handle it physically. But you know what we did sign last year and this year, we believe is going to be able to push on the club in terms of a long-term goal, and also the senior players within the group that maybe think that their position's almost guaranteed within the team. And you know, I think Richard Wilkinson showed last year that that's not the case. And along with Alex Starling, who played a number of games, and Ryan Wilson too, who were all fantastic for the club.
Yeah, I can vouch for that. They were all good, and you know, a few of the fans, they know who these people are now, whereas obviously last season you took a little bit of a bit of flack from people after the pre-season games, you know, saying we've signed a lot of young kids from Hull. Well, I've already mentioned earlier that you know what you're doing, and the same thing's happening this year. We've picked up a couple there, you know, Josh Kittrick and Sam Doherty. How did you come across them two?
Yeah, again, through agents and through people within the game that we trust and know. Myself, Chris Spare, done some homework on these boys. And again, at 19, these boys have nowhere to go and play, and we try and pick a couple of, not bargains, but, you know, some players that maybe turn out, you know, from rocks to diamonds. And we picked up one in particular, as I say, Richard Wilkinson last year, and Alex Starling, Ryan Wilson. I'll keep mentioning them three because they came on board late and they played well for us. But, you know, these boys are in their own right. Josh in particular reminds me a lot of Wilco. A tidy footballer at the line, he squares up well. You know, not about as big as Rich Wilco with regards to his stature, and that's something we'll work on in the off-season. And there's got to be an element of trust from people within the group of what I'm trying to do and achieve, as well as from outside the group with fans and supporters of the club. There's got to be an element of trust. It's why I'm paid to do the job I'm doing. And it's why we're paid to be in the positions that we're in as coaches and as staff members, you know, managers or whatever that may be. So, you know, there's got to be an element of trust from everybody, and you know, we may get it wrong with some of them. We don't dispute that, but we're hoping that 9 times out of 10 we get these boys right, and they come on leaps and bounds, and they push the average age of the squad down on match day with their performance in training and games. So, you know, they're there to kick the backside of the players that we've got and move the club forward long term.
Yeah, and then the other one that's new is Brad Foster. One thing that struck me with these players when you got them in and I'd first met them and all that was their attitudes were very, very first class. I thought they were all genuine kids and genuinely want to do well for themselves, genuinely want to have a crack, well-mannered, respectful boys. Mm-hmm. And that's what struck me with them straight away, and they're the sort of people, as you know, that I want around the place, and they're not really focused straight away on trying to make the team straight away. What they were focused more on was coming to the club because of yourself a lot, and they openly said that, and wanting to develop themselves, which it really hit me that, you know, they wanted to be here and they weren't going to, you know, spit the dummy out if they didn't get picked, and they want to better themselves and challenge themselves and challenge the bigger boys. But, you know, when they left the office, I just thought, gee, we're getting some real good boys at the club.
Yeah, it's important. I did a presentation to the players at the back end of last season about player retention, and it incorporates recruitment as well. You know, if you're no good off the field, but you're a really good player, then we can manage you. Mm. If you're good on the field and off the field, then we'll keep you or try and sign you. You know, if you're not so good on the field, but you're great off it, then we can coach you. And if you're neither of the above, then we'll get rid of you. You know, if you're no good off the field and no good around the place and no good for the place, and you're bringing a non-energising culture and behave like a duck egg, then your performances better be good, because if they're not, then we'll get rid and we won't retain you and we won't recruit you. What's important is to develop the boys, the younger players in particular, not only as a rugby player but as a human being, and you know, I'm certainly one that made a fair number of errors off the field in my career, and can pass on that experience to the players about where it can land you and which kind of trouble it can land you in. So, you know, we need to develop these players, not only as players, but as human beings, and make them well-rounded and well-grounded and well-mannered and respectful. And that's something that we adhere to at the place. It's, you know, don't let the team down, but don't let yourself down or the club down, and behave off the field in a manner which is unacceptable. And, you know, the players that we've signed, we've done our own work on with regards what culture they're going to bring. And we've had one or two players that have been recommended to us that can play that their attitude off the field, we've been told, has been no good, so we've just not pursued the signing of them players, even though they probably maybe benefit the team. You know, we're trying here to achieve something long term, and you know, we go to last season, and the short and long term aim was to make the eight because we needed to be in the league we was in, but the pitch has changed for us this year. We need to look more long term, and I don't just mean 12 months, but I mean 2 years, 3 years, 4 years down the line.
Yeah, I agree. And the last one that I'm really looking forward to seeing him get back out there, and he's been for a tough old slog, Brett Weller. He's not far off now, and he's agreed to stay with us, and I'm pretty sure, you know, everyone will be real happy about that with the loss of Mark Castle. And, you know, Brett, I think, will be like a new player coming to us. All the conversations I've had with him, he said he's like a kid in a candy store. You just can't wait. So, you know, how forward are you looking to have him back?
Yeah, he'll be big for us. Obviously, we're losing Mark. You know, and just on Mark Castle and the other players that have left, we've got obviously Mark Castle, Nev Morrison, and Liam Cunningham who've left the group. You know, we didn't want to lose these players, if I'm honest, but we just felt that, you know, with the restraints and the financial restraints on the club and the amount of game time that these boys had played in the past, that, you know, we couldn't maybe offer them a contract which was worthy of where they think they are, with regards to the rest of the group. And, you know, we tried to retain these players, but there was given offers elsewhere. Barring Neville, who agreed to join York before we'd spoken to him, with the constraints on us and everything else with regards to the club. But these players choose to leave, and with our best wishes. We certainly wish Liam, Nev and Mark all the very best in the future endeavours, unless they come to the keep, obviously, or we play them away from home. But they've been fantastic for the group, Mark in particular, over a number of years. You know, but we need to move this group of players on, and Brett, like you say, will be a new player to us. He's a big player. You know, was looking forward to getting him on the field last year. He'd shed a number of kilograms in the off season, and unfortunately never played a minute for us in the league campaign in competitive football. So he's working hard. I know that he works really hard himself to get himself fit and right, and he has done since his operation last year and beginning of the season. So we're looking forward to him getting back on board, and along with you know, a signing we're still to announce, we'll certainly be more than adequate in the front row, we believe, and And again, we need to push the club forward, and we need players in the place that have got the right attitude, and Brett's certainly got that, and we're looking forward to getting him back into the pre-season and the next season's campaign.
Righto, it seems like we've got a fair old squad. Is that part of your plan to increase the squad this year?
Yeah, massive. You know, we started with probably 24 last year, and then we lost Dennis Tufour early, and Michael Butterfield left the club, and Alex Starling went midway through the season for a scholarship in America. So we certainly lose a few. We gained a couple in Steve Snitch and a bargain there, and there'll be some more business done, no doubt, you know, throughout the season. We've not closed the door on Tom Hodgson, who's returning to Rugby Union, and you know, we've one or two more irons in the pipeline with regards to Rugby Union and when their season finishes. So what's imperative for us is to make the squad younger and to push the senior players on with the signings that we're making, and push the squad and team on, not just in 2015 but beyond 2016, 17 and 18, and where we see the long-term aim of the club being and for us to get to.
Real good. There you have it. That's in-depth in the office dugout with Paul Cooke, and you know, hope he's answered a few questions out there, and this is what we're going to try and do. We'll get some players in, and we'll have Paul back again to speak to us again. So cheers, Paul, and thanks for your honesty, mate.
No, thank you.